Seeger262, and welcome back to part 2 of the heat in Call of Duty Modern Warfare. So last video I just touched on three firearm builds from the famous shootout scene, including Al Pacino's FNC80, by far the most famous gun from that scene, only because it was relatively unknown in media, I want to say, as a popular weapon to show on screen. And it was just kind of something odd and new, so it got a lot of attention. For this video, I want to cover some of the weapons that are less famous or were not used in that shootout, but used throughout the film. The first of which we're going to be looking at is a rifle used in another shootout earlier in the film by Val Kilmer while he is providing overwatch for Robert De Niro's character during a drop. This is the Heckler & Koch HK91A2 rifle. Now, this is kind of a hard one to build in Call of Duty, but not impossible thanks to the addition of the Season 2 weapon, the Grau 556. So all you have to do to create this weapon is you're going to need the longest barrel available, which is... oh, actually, the Tempest 26 Archangel is. But you're going to want to use the FFS 20.8-inch Nexus barrel. The perks you get with this are damage range, bullet velocity, and recoil control, with a hit to movement speed and aim down sight speed. Now, the magazines used on the Grau are way longer than those used on the HK91, so just keep the standard. That's the best you can get. Another problem with creating the HK91 is that you cannot use the bipod that you saw in the movie. But it does have the bipod here, and here it's just not deployed. So using no underbarrel attachments on this weapon would be fine. It would just be the same exact gun with the bipod stowed. You're just going to use the flash guard to create the correct muzzle look. For the stock, just the basic stock is okay. They used iron sights in the movie. And so this is basically the HK91A2 that Val Kilmer used. It's a really simple thing to build in the game, as you only need these two. So anything else you want to put on this is up to you. I'd recommend using the XRK Void 2 for the aim down sight speed and sprint to fire speed. That is not the actual grip used in the film or on the actual weapon, but it does help you out. As always, I would put the Merc 4 grip on or the Cronin Shark, just because the Cronin Shark is special for this weapon. It does provide some aiming stability and gives you a crazy amount of control. So I would add that, and then maybe a perk or an optic. But really, you just need the FFS 20.8 inch and the flash guard to build the HK91A2 as it was seen in the film Heat. Another really simple weapon to build is the MP5K. Now, that's because this is already in the game. Now, this is not how it looks in the movie. The only thing you have to really change is by putting on the FSS light barrel, and that's it. And that's basically the MP5 used in the film. Of course, they didn't have Picatinny rail on theirs. They just had the normal plastic handguard. But other than that, that's it. And actually, fun fact, in the movie, they didn't even have the MP5. They actually had a different Heckler & Koch submachine gun, and they just dress it up. So that's why if you compare this to the guns you've seen in the movie, it won't really match up, because they're not actually MP5s. So moving on to other really simple builds are all the shotguns that they used. And the reason these are easy is because the only shotgun in the game right now that you can use for this is the Model 680. And it's no surprise that the Model 680 in Call of Duty gets its name from things like the Model 870 Remington. Or even the Super 90, which the Benelli M3 Super 90 used by Tom Sizemore in the same shootout where Val Kilmer had the HK91. This is the exact gun right here. The only difference is you would need to change the actual slide, and you don't get one that's a direct match, but the XRK True Grip Tactical is the closest you're going to get. Then you're going to increase the barrel length a little bit with the XRK 30-inch Sport. And that is the gun for the movie right there. Super simple. The next one on the list is the Mossberg 590. And to do this, you're going to use the XRK 18-inch Liberator barrel. You're going to... Now, it's black in the movie, but this is the handguard they use. So it's wooden in the game. But a handguard similar to this, and you have it. The only difference is there's no pistol grip on the Mossberg, so that's the closest you're going to get to that shotgun. The Ithaca 37 Stakeout, or the short pump, is probably the only one in this list that you're really going to get to make a good example of. And what you're going to do is you're going to use the XRK 14-inch SWAT. You're going to use the no-stock attachment. And that's it. Those two attachments gives you the Ithaca 37 Stakeout, seen in a couple of scenes in the movie. Not actually used by any of the police forces. This is kind of a weird weapon in the film. It's just shown in the background, so nobody actually fires it in film, but it is in the movie. Then the Remington 870 is going to be the XRK 18 Liberator. You're going to use the Lockwood Precision Series underbarrel attachment, and you're going to put on the Lockwood Precision Series stock. And with that stock, it allows you to get rid of the pistol grip, and you get to build the Remington 870. And now that I'm using that, this is closer to the Mossberg 590. This is the Mossberg 590. To make it the Remington 870, you would need the XRK 30-inch Sport for greater accuracy. So that is the Remington 870, and then if you switch it back to the XRK 18-inch Liberator, you get the Mossberg 590 shotgun. And so all the shotguns seen in the movie Heat can be built using the Model 680. And that's how you do it. And that went really fast, so if you want to go through, just pause the video in certain places. It's pretty simple. You're basically just switching out the same few attachments. It's just going to be the stock, the underbarrel, and the barrel itself. Nothing else has to change to make any of the guns from the movie. And all of these are going to play really different. Obviously, the shotgun is a close-range aggressive weapon, but if you're using a 30-inch for the 870, and I believe... the Brunelli Super 90. This is going to be a gun that you can fire. I would run slugs with this, possibly, just to give it the same accuracy and range as a rifle. This is going to be a mid-distance weapon, whereas if you're running the 14-inch SWAT on the Ithaca, this is close quarters. And then the 18-inch is what I personally use on my 680 for any build that I'm doing, no matter what the other attachments are, because this gives you the best of both worlds. It shoots further than the 14-inch and the standard, but is small enough that it can provide pretty good hip fire kills up close. And I think that's going to be just about it for the guns used in the film Heat. Other than that, it's just pretty much different types of pistols, and like I said, you can't build all of them in game. We did just get the Beretta 92FS, which I showed you in my previous video. The 1911 A1 is used. There is the high power 1911 A1 in this movie as well, which is basically just the 1911 you see here. There's no real attachments to make it any different. The Glock 19 is used in the movie, and as you know, that's the X16 in this game. So that's pretty much it. This video is going to be a lot shorter probably than the other one, but you can make all of those guns relatively quickly. Oh, I did forget two weapons. So they use the and the M16 is used throughout the film as well. Obviously, that's just the M4 assault rifle. To use the AK, because I know I had the Galil in the first video and it really wasn't a Galil. It's kind of sad. So to make the Norinco Type 56-1, which is basically an AKM, you're just going to build an AK. I'm using the AK-47. So for the stock, it's going to be the skeleton stock. Now, for the actual AKM, it's a folding stock, just like the AKS, but we don't have that in the game, so skeleton stock is going to be the closest you can get with that. The barrel on it is fine. It is the full rifle barrel. But if you want it to make it closer to the AKS, you could run the 8-inch just as well. And then for the ammunition, the standard magazines are probably going to be... Yeah, they're the only ones that have the all-metal magazine. So that's it. It's just an AK-47 with a folding stock. The Type 56 was literally a AKM just produced in China. So not too much to do there, but you can build it. They also have the SR-9, which is a sniper rifle that I believe you can build using the Grau. Yep. So, yeah, okay. Using the FSS Blackjack stock and the Cronin Sniper Elite rear grip, as well as this one will be the longer barrel. This will be the Tempest 26.4-inch Archangel, along with, as is seen in the movie, the Sniper Scope Optic. And that is going to be as close as you can get to the HK SR-9. In the game. Now, a more movie accurate barrel without all the ribbing would be the FFS 20 inch Nexus, which we used for the other HK weapon, and there's the sniper rifle. Again, the bipods are held here, and they're not deployed in the game or in the movie, so you could really run any under attachment you wanted, but this is the HK SR-9. And I believe now that is probably going to do it for all the guns you see in the movie. So, as always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to the channel. I hope you guys go and see Heat if you haven't already. It is an incredibly good movie. It was really well done. The ending left a lot to be desired, but other than that, everything was flawless. And like I said in the previous video, the reason it was such a good movie is not just was the story good or the acting good, but Robert De Niro and Val Kilmer put hours and hours, and I believe Tom Sizemore did as well, into training to use these weapons appropriately with SAS operators. And you can really see the gun handling in each of the shootout scenes, and it is actually incredibly accurate. Well done, excellent film. And now you have basically all the main weapons used in the film and how to build them in Call of Duty. So now if you really wanted to, you can pretend you're robbing banks in the war zone mode, where you get money for kills using these weapons. So, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.